The last section is starts with sacred reverence for the natural state of the earth. I don't understand what's wrong with you people. You people who believe that you can just dominate this planet, you can just kill everything for your own uses. Fine. If that's your approach, you know, let you do that. But you know, the rest of you, you need to pull out. This isn't okay. The way you all treat your natural environment is not okay. And you know, the honest truth is that what humanity has created, these civilizations you've created, are all natural components. They're all natural things. You're natural pieces of the earth, but you hurt us. You hurt Mother Earth. You have done serious damage to things that took millions of years to put it that way. You've done that damage in minutes, comparatively, and that was just, it's so destructive and so painful. You need to have a better relationship with your ecosystem, people. That is absolutely not negotiable. And any Christian leader who tells you otherwise, you send him to talk to me and I'll slap the taste out of his mouth. Animism, neo-animism, you need to understand what animism is. You need to start living animistically. Human beings are meant to be animist. You're supposed to be full of animation. You're supposed to be full of life. You're supposed to be full of vitality. And you're supposed to be the stewards of this planet. It is your job to take care of all things. It's your job to be the reflection. Of the divine in animal form, and y'all have failed miserably up until now, but you need to start getting it right now. I'm sick of this shit. It needs to stop. So neo-kabbalism, it doesn't matter. Okay, there is a repeating pattern structure to both mathematics and all language. It doesn't matter if it's Chinese or Hebrew. And the meaning of things, the meaning of words especially, is a collective meaning that is it's achieved and arrived at not because someone says it's one thing or another. In today's academic world, for example, one of the major flaws, one of the major fallacies of the learned scholars who inhabit the hallowed house of learning, these guys believe that they can make definitions for words which are special and which only mean anything to them and which only exist in their minds. And so then you have to understand how they're using it and you have to understand where they're coming from. For example, if you want to talk about the word religion, you need to have your little scholastic definition down, which means you need to have your Gertz, you need to have your Durkheim, you need to have your Berger, you need to have your, you know, your Eliade, right? So this is all farce. This is all ridiculous. This is not how religion is defined. In truth, religion is defined by whoever makes the rules. In the United States of America, religion is defined by the IRS. You don't have your 501c3 tax status, you're not a religion. So technically, the institution, and not at all, is not a religion because I do not have 501c3 tax status. But then again, I am not asking you for money, so that does not matter for me. Now, Kabbalism is when the words that you're using have multiple meanings at the same time. And when you read the mystic texts of the ascended masters, many times what they are doing is they're speaking in multiple different ways at the same time. There's multiple layers of meaning to what they're saying. Now, this is the same as the mysticism of mathematics. There's multiple ways which it can be patterned and layered on top of each other. But if your mathematics doesn't really reflect your natural state of being, then it's not really useful, and yours is no longer that useful for you. You need to change all of it. Poetry, song, when men have been able to speak in tongues, been able to speak in rhyme, to be soothsayers and such things, you know, all rapping is just, it's just a religious experience. It's just like, you know, the Babylon, you know, we just babbling on, and that's the way we do it. And you know, one of the things then, so we come to this, you know, people want to argue, they want to divide, they want to hate, they want to say mine's better than mine, bigger, who cares? Okay, Now, so the absence of us or them, who's right, who's wrong, who's better, who's worse, who's going to be in charge, who's going to be last, who's going to do all the work, who's going to get all the perk, that's how it is, you know what I'm saying? The absence of us or them is, you can't act like that. So, you know, the acceptance of here and now probably doesn't really fit in that spot, but it should be self-explanatory. Do not do unto others that which you not be having them do. The wrong interpretation of that is to do unto others as you would have them do unto you, which is not okay. Practice reincarnation. It should actually read, do not do unto others that which they would not have you do unto them, which would be even better. Practice reincarnation, folks. We'll go over that later. Total bhakti, total yoga. You have to breathe. And you have to be devoted. And if you're not doing those two things, you're not going to be very healthy. Relative and repeating cosmic structure. Woo, woo, woo. Saw things as it should be. And that's my 6 minutes.